Welcome back to Hot Coffee. We're talking with Caloocan Bishop Deogracias Iniguez Jr., head of the CBCP Public Affairs Committee. We have questions from Facebook and Twitter, Bishop, and I'll read them to you now. Jovi Miroy asks, what are the chances of the church banning the use of tarpaulins in the sanctuary? Shouldn't the tabernacle and other sacramentals be enough reminders?
Well,
mass form of advertising.
Well, tarpaulins can have their place since these are now widely used. Mm-hmm. No? But that's right. Any form of advertisement mm-hmm. or information that is posted inside the church mm-hmm. should be done within a proper parameter.
All
no?
right. Okay.
It should be.
Huwag yung maabuso siya na wag, it's all over
na
the place.
Mawawala ng maisasantabi no, yung ibang mas mahalagang mga parts okay. of the church.
Chasing Rach asks, what's your view on the so-called virtual Bisita Iglesia where netizens don't go to actual churches and instead take the tour with the use of the internet? I remember I did a story on this last year and I recall, if I recall correctly, the CBCP did this primarily for our kababayans na OFWs. Yeah. Who are abroad and abroad. In Muslim
That's
countries
right.
who can't go out and physically see churches. But there are some who opt to do this here, to be in the comforts of their own home. will it count? Is it the same for them? Will they get the same effect of being able to see a church and pray in those churches? What's your view on that?
Well, visita iglesia is a practice that is carried out on Holy Thursday night mm-hmm. and the morning of First Friday
okay.
in order to continue the celebration of Holy Thursday evening, which is the Mass of the Last Supper. Mm-hmm. And here, as the first of the sacred Triduum, we celebrate the institution of the Holy Eucharist, mm-hmm. where one of the truths that we believe is that Jesus is truly present mm-hmm. by virtue of that act of the Holy Eucharist.
Okay.
And so Jesus remains with us in what we call the Blessed Sacrament. Mm-hmm. And in order to focus on that, we have this exposition. During that period, the remaining species, the remaining bread from the Holy Eucharist celebration is exposed for adoration.
Okay.
And people go now to the church mm-hmm. in order to adore Jesus present there sacramentally, and that we call the visita iglesia.
Okay.
So there's not even a need to go into to several churches, no? Mm-hmm. Just to go there in order to acknowledge and to adore Jesus present among us. That's mm-hmm. the real spirit, Jesus mm-hmm. who died on the cross and who will rise again.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are many who may not be able to do this.
Right.
No? Those who are far away, yep. especially in countries where the practice of religion is so limited, is banned. There are also those who are sick
yes,
no, here in
home.
Our country.
Yes. Mm.
So they cannot go. And there are those for one reason or another, mm-hmm. no, they really cannot go to visit the Blessed Sacrament. Mm-hmm. So for this, what we call virtual visita iglesia can be very, very helpful.
It can be helpful for them. All right. Well, before we go, Bishop, I'd like to ask you to give your message. I hope I don't preempt any masses you may be holding over the weekend, that you may be giving a special message to our kababayans and our brothers and sisters out there. But as well, please do address our viewers and give your Holy Week message for them.
So Holy Week is the height of our celebration of faith. It is here that we enter into a deeper understanding through the celebration, the sacramental celebration of the Paschal mystery. And so all of us Catholics, all of us Christians are invited to enter into these celebrations of faith. And the best way that we can do this is actually to participate actively and intelligently. That means we understand and we try to enter into these celebrations with our full person, with our mind and with our heart. So I invite all of you really to participate in these liturgical celebrations. Although it is only the celebration on Easter that is obligatory for
right.
us because
mm-hmm.
that's Sunday.
Right.
So all the other celebrations in the church are not obligatory.
Optional.
But the best way for us really to enter into the Holy Week and to understand it and to celebrate it and to benefit from it is to understand what these celebrations are and to participate in them. And it is from these celebrations, from this spirit, that all the other practices should really flow and should have their meaning.
All right. Well, on that note, we want to thank you so much for joining us, Kalaokan Bishop Deogracias Iniguez Jr. Thank you po so much.
Most and have welcome, a and thank you for this opportunity. And I really pray that all of us will have, especially with the help of this program, to have a significant celebration of faith during the Holy Week.
Thank you so much, and all the best. God bless. Thank you.
Thomas Jr.
Yes, Thomas Jr. He asked me what TJ stood for. Well, and that's Head Start today, folks. I'm Thomas Manotok Jr., as the Bishop said. Have a blessed Lenten season, everyone, and we'll see you again next week.